Welcome, people. I know this is different from what I usually share, but this is just an introduction to the whole tutorial series. This is not a rant. This is organized speech. I'm La Sombra Demon, stage maker of a very few creations. Been around Mugen scene for 20 years, since the US Mugen days. You could say I'm one of the veterans. And since then, I've been dreaming of making the World Heroes 2 Deathmatch mode stages. Yeah, very specific, eh? So when this new retro-compatible engine, Ikemen Go, allowed us to make true interactive stages, I went nuts and made a gazillion interactive set pieces for it. Note, I don't make the stages themselves, only the portions that truly react to player stuff. And well, you all notice I'm pushing for Ikemen Go with enthusiasm, and this has multiple reasons. I've seen the original Mugen devs like Byte come and go over the years. Mugen is closed source and, as of today, abandonware. Sticking to abandonware software when there are updated options is not a good idea for a ton of reasons that go beyond the scope of this video. But it's worth saying that I've seen the development of other clones like Paintown, Rakis, Infinity Cut and Shugendo, to name some of the most advanced Mugen clones. All of them being closed source, their development stopped once the people in charge lost interest or just couldn't go on. Ikemen Go being open source means this is very, very unlikely to happen, and it currently has over half a dozen active devs, which is really cool. This leads to increasingly better retro compatibility and less bugs. Ikemen Go is indeed supporting more and more Mugen creations without porting at all, just copy your characters and stages as usual. Same goes for screen packs, life bars and spark sets. Many of the new particular Ikemen Go features can be done in Mugen in full game or semi-full game environments via certain hacky solutions. Add004 and other systems try to fake tag, and some have used other mechanisms to fake stage interaction, to name a few examples. But Mugen was not really designed for this, and it is not really supported. Just because you can't pull it off, it doesn't mean it's an optimal solution. Copy-pasting code into every character is not an optimal solution, in my opinion. True new features are awesome. This is what Ikemen Go brings. Proper tag, proper announcers, unlockables, writing to disk from your characters, netplay with rollback, and yes, the reason you're here for, interactive stages. Well, and now onto the tutorial series. This is sort of a syllabi. I am first going to tell you what we will not teach in the series, so you are not disappointed. Mugen stage making, basic or advanced, is not going to be taught here, since Cyberstage tutorial is the most complete one by far, and it's worth checking. I am going to leave a link below. Stage making can be basic or advanced, according to Elegbyte's own words, depending on whether BG controllers are used. We are not going to cover character making, how to make an animation air file, an SFF, an SMD file, how to code basic stuff in CNS. We're not going to cover that. There are many tutorials about those, and that is way bigger than the scope of this series. What you require, what I'm going to expect you to have. Fighter Factory, any version to just open the SFFs and check out the animations mostly. Notepad++ to code. Maybe a spreadsheet of some sorts to maybe generate some effects with animations. And the docs and wikis open at all times, especially the triggers and state controllers, and you have to be willing to read a lot. This is crucial. No video series is going to just teach you without any sort of effort on your part to code and create anything. You have to put some time and effort into it. So, what you will learn with this series. Some basic Mugen history on fake interactive stages and some Ikemen history. What each engine can and cannot do. What is this attach char feature, its basic characteristics. How to use and install interactive stages and how to make a small interactive breakable object. some advanced tools useful for a touch char and code tidbits that will save you time and effort, secrets of the trade, if you will. Then we're going to go back to the basics. How to design in paper to avoid coding problems. How and when to make a bonus stage with an attached char, when is it worth it? And a basic introduction to CSS, the new and optional Ikemen language, which is much, much more powerful than CNS. For the last video, I'm planning to fully show you how to code four truly interactive set pieces, a spike drop, a healing item, another item that increases damage done by the player, and an automatic stage fatal. So Mortal Kombat and Killer Instinct and Eternal Champions fans, you better watch them. Well, here's hoping you enjoy what's coming and that you use it to make tons and tons of cool stuff. Stay tuned, first vid coming soon.